Welcome to Analytics with Nags. This is another video in the Paginated Reports where I'm going to talk about row groups and column groups in Paginated Reports. If you can see from the bottom, here you have row groups and column groups. Once you started designing your Paginated Reports, you will find something when you have table visual in your charts, in the Paginated Reports. You will find some columns added when you keep adding the records here, right? So what is the purpose of it and when to use it? That is what we are going to see as part of this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. This channel contains 75,000 INR worth contents, which covers MSBI, Power BI, SQL Server. So please utilize this content freely available to you and share with your friends and colleagues. With this note, let us begin our today's topic. So I'm in Paginated Reports. So I'm going to create a simple region and product category reports. So let's try to add a data source. I will quickly add it. We are already familiar with how to add such a data source here. So let me quickly do it for you. So this is your data source. And I will add a data set here. I will try to choose the data source from here, whatever created previously just now a few minutes back. Now I need to choose the what are my data sets. As I indicated in the report, it is sales report by region as well as the product category. So I need all those things. So let us try to get the quantity, order quantity, and the sales amount from the fact. Only these two things I needed from here. And from product, I have a product name. Let's get the product name from here. And the product subcategory, English product subcategory, and product category name. And then, as I said, I need the region. I have this region from the sales territory. I will bring region, country, and group. Okay, and also I would like to get some year. So let us go for calendar year now from the dim date. So these are the fields I need: order quantity, product category, subcategory, region, country, and group. So these are my fields I require for this report. Let's try enter. And as we see in our previous issues, when you choose the date, the date is related three times in the fact table, so all the columns are mapped. So we will face issues, so try to remove it, otherwise you will not get the reports, right? So only one join, that is only based on the sales order date. Other two joins you can remove it. Just click on it. Okay, I'm not doing any naming for it. I can say like sales. Okay, I'm doing it very quick because these are the things, preliminary things that we have already discussed. So we have a data set now. Let us try to understand these row groups and column groups. So let me bring this table here. And as soon as you drag and drop, you see the details figure. What I'm trying to say is like, let us try to add some values over here. Category and region, and I will say order quantity. Now you can see there is no column groups or row groups. Only in the row groups we have something called details, the three lines over here, which indicates like whatever you got in this data set, say for example 1,000 rows, all those 1,000 rows will be displayed as part of this table. That is what it meaning. So when you click on run and see the reports, you can see the report keep goes on for different pages because it is designed like a details. This is what not I want. I want to build something like a group of report. Like I want, if there is 5 countries, I want to display 5 countries in a row. And if there are three product category in the column, just like a pivot or on matrix table. So either you can do the table or matrix using both. I will show the table using table visual, how you can do it, and similar results you can achieve using a matrix as well. So table, so basically to give a short explanation, these row groups, column groups, use it to group by of your columns in your data set to display the results. That is what it will do. Now I don't want the details anymore, and before doing that I need to choose like the details I don't want now. So I can before deleting, I can choose the data set. I can assign a data set to this table. So where I can assign it, you can, once you choose this table X here, right, you can have a data set name. Okay, once you come here, you have a data set, only single data set, that's why it's appearing sales. You map the data set name to the, in general tab, first thing is data set name. Once you click on the table, then it will appear. You see, ensure you are touch the table here. Then I don't want a table anymore, just click delete rows. Okay, then here coming to, you want country wise data, right? Or yeah, I will have a group first, then followed by a country. So I want, instead of adding directly the sales territory group, right click and do the add group. I want row groups, which is nothing but your group by. So I want the parent group first. So before first group, what you want? I want the parent group as the group, the sales territory group. Okay, when I press OK, then it is fine. On the next column, what I want? I want the country. So here, next, again in the row group, you say like add group, you say like child group. So child group will sit under the parent group. So now once I add, you can able to understand child group. I want the country. Okay, now you see here one level down, and also you can see from the diagram, instead of three lines, okay, earlier in details three lines appear, now it was like open parenthesis, like over here. So we have two groups here, one is a sales territory group and then one for the country, we have added it. And also I can add the total for these groups, so like add total after. So you either you can do after or before, I will do the after. Once you keep like this, then you will find something like you will have only one entry for this group. Underneath, if you have three countries, it will display. So like this, it will display for you. So this is what your row group. First, you need to add a parent group. Underneath, you will have a child group. Then similarly, let's try to run this report without having anything, and we will see how it looks. Now you can see the report looks like this. You have a group, Europe, North America, Pacific. Underneath, you have the different countries. So you do not map anything over here. Either you can remove these columns without the column groups. You can still hold the same report by mapping directly the order quantity or sales amount, whatever it is. But I want to show you the row column groups as well, how it looks like. Now when you right click on it, you can go to add group. In the column group, either you can add again the row group or column group. I want to do the column group now. So there is no column group earlier, that is why only parent group appearing. First you need to add parent group, then only you can go for a child group. So once you add a parent group for the column group, in this I want to see different product category. Okay, once I had that one, you can see the product category started appearing here at the top, that will be mapped already. Then what values you want to show. So once you click on it, you can see like I want to see the order quantity. I don't want to go for order amount now. Let us see like how it appears. Now once you added it here, let's try to run the report and see how it behaves. Now you can see from the diagram, this is the parent group for the row group, and this is the child group for the row group. Okay, two things appear, and this is the parent group, only one group available in the column group, that is product category. So these three appear. What is these two blank rows? You can see these two blank rows appeared. So basically, once you design your report, how it will expand based on the data, After expanding, there are two blank rows, so that also appeared. So this is how you need to imagine, okay, the adding the column and row groups. And in this, you want to add some summation or average of those things, you can still add it, no problem with that. So this is how you need to add. Now in this, I will again add some kind of child group here. Let us try to add it. So I will add over here, like child group, I will say like instead of product category, I will say calendar year. Okay, for each year, how much it has appeared. So this is the child group. Let us try to see how it looks like now. Now you can see from the diagram, in the accessories below each year, you got the data. So this is how you can add the child and column groups, the parent groups and child groups. So now let us quickly format these records. You can press shift control. I will say blue bold, and for this also I will say blue bold, and I will give some color to this over here. Let's go for yellow, same, and for this I will say like light blue. Let's see how it looks like. You can see from the diagram, this is looking just a little neat. Like you can still have a ability to format. For this also, you can choose the same color so that it will appear properly. And you can also name it. So now you can see from this, you have a total, and for the total, you can have different colors if you want. And this is how you can able to configure your row groups and column groups. Basically, you need to do the group by of your tables. And I can still have the same results using the matrix. By default, I hope the matrix is having the what you call the row group and column group. Let's try to expand this report and then let's see how it looks. Now you see by default in the table visual you had a three lines. By default matrix is part of, you already had a two groups over here. That's why when you have a matrix visual, you already choose one column here, the same column. We will repeat here, you will get some data in a grouping. So similarly, we can add over here what we had, category name. And how to add a new column, just go here, add group, child group, then here I will say product group and the country here, okay, sales group country, same thing. And I need to choose this guy, I mean that group, then add total. Once you add a total, so this will appear once, and underneath whatever countries appear, that will appear, started appearing here. So let us do the same formatting here, and let's try to add another group, the child group here, and I can say calendar year again, and let's try to launch it now and see the results. So you might have asked me why we need to go for the table or matrix. If you can able to achieve some result, I mean, why we need to exactly go for such a things, I'm pretty much not sure. I will definitely come back with some answers. But these are the some of the properties you can think of. When to go for a table, when to go for matrix, that is different part of the story. I will take a separate video if time permits, but you need to understand what is this row group and column group, when to add, how to add it. That is the main purpose of this video. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.